Hello students, in fact this is my third session on some important problems for entrance preparation, and I have already mentioned to you that these set of videos will be the short and crisp videos which will concentrate on 4 to 5 problems per video, so that it will become easy even for you also to go ahead and practice these questions. And we can take a look at furtherance of all the problems step by step. Okay, I hope you all are doing safely nice at your home during this lockdown period. I wish you all the great success before I begin with this video. So let's take a look at today's set of problems. Today I have selected 4 interesting problems. 2 from JE exam and 2 problems I have selected from AIPMT, that is NEET examination. Okay, so let us take a look at our first problem. The problem is like this: a body of mass m equal to 20 gram is attached to an elastic spring of length L is equal to 50 centimeter and spring constant K is equal to 2 newton per meter. The system is revolved in a horizontal plane with a frequency of 30 revolutions per minute. The radius of circular motion and the tension in the spring are, okay. So the options, various options given to us are like this. You all can go through these options, okay. So I suppose this problem involves the rigid body based rotational motion kind of approach is there, but here I'll be applying laws of motion. That is a very simple approach. So let us go ahead and take a look at the solution of this problem. Okay, fine then. Now let's take a look at the solution to this problem. What are the given things that we'll just list down? Mass is given to us, so I am converting it directly to kg. Length is given to us, I am converting it to meter. So mass is 0.02 kg here and length is 0.5 meter. Okay, so accordingly K is given to us as 2 newton per meter, spring constant. Then frequency is given in terms of revolutions per minute, so I am converting it into revolutions per second. Okay, so it is 30/60, which is 0.5 hertz, 0.5 revolutions per second. We can consider like this. Okay, so now accordingly, what all things we should find? We should find radius and tension. So I'm taking radius as small r and tension as capital T. Okay, so these are the two things that we are supposed to find. Now let's take a look at first step. So here, firstly, I'll calculate angular frequency or angular velocity. Omega is equal to, we know the formula that omega is 2 pi f, and here I have already found the frequency. So accordingly, I can very easily go ahead and write the value of angular frequency as pi radian per second. Correct? So this is step one. So in the second step, I'll be taking care of the force due to the spring. Okay, so that is elastic spring force. I am taking it as F, that is equal to K into X. Okay, this is from dynamics of spring. So from that, I am considering F is equal to KX, and X I am taking it to be the extension. And for your information, my friends, this force, spring force, is nothing but the tension that we are supposed to calculate. Okay, so here extension is unknown. So as a matter of fact, we'll find that value of X. Okay, in order to do that, we should follow this simple approach. R is equal to L plus X, because X is the extension of the spring, or we can say X is the length or displacement through which the spring is extended, and L is what? L is the length of the spring, initial length. So obviously, accordingly, L plus X will give me what? Radius of the revolution. And the spring system is revolved like this in horizontal plane. Okay, so Accordingly, I can very easily find the value of R by using centripetal force. Is it not? Fine. So, hence, we will calculate centripetal force, that is nothing but the tension in the spring or tension in the system. And centripetal force is defined by m omega square into R. So, this formula I already know, which is mv square by R or m omega square into R. So, accordingly, I'll be entering into the third step to calculate the tension. T is equal to F under equilibrium, that I am stating. Already I have mentioned to you. Okay. Then M omega square R must be taken equal to what? K into X, because K into X is the spring force. So obviously when these two are connected like this, okay, under equilibrium, I am taking this equation. So accordingly, I'll be substituting this R value as L plus X here, okay, and omega is a pi, so accordingly I am mentioning this equation, and then I'll multiply everything and take out X as common. So I think this simple step you all can do, okay. So accordingly, I'll be obtaining this particular equation for X here, ML omega square divided by K minus M into omega square, okay. So this is the value of X, that is the extension or displacement of the mass connected to the spring. Okay, fine. So accordingly, I'll substitute the values here. So I know mass value, I know L, I know omega value, and I know K value. Hence, I can substitute all these factors and then calculate the value of spring extension. It comes or works out to be approximately around 0.05 meter. Which I have rounded off actually. Actually, you will be getting a value of something like 0.0498 something. Okay. So, accordingly, I will be getting it as 0.05 meter. This is the extension. So, this is that unknown factor that I have already calculated. Okay. Then, our next step is quite simple now. Since I know the value of X, I can find R as well. Because length of the spring is given to us, initial length, which is 0.5, okay, and 0.05 meter is the calculated value of X. So accordingly, I will be getting the value of R, that is radius of revolution, as 0.55 meter. I hope it is clear. Fine. Now let's move on to the next value, that is tension. Tension can be calculated as F is equal to KX, correct? So accordingly, 2 into 0.05, that should give me what? 0.1 Newton. So accordingly, the answer to this particular problem, it happens to be option D. Okay, fine. So I think this approach is clear. Fine. So you please repeat this video, observe the solution steps, and then be thorough in such varieties of problems. Okay, this problem is a hot favorite pick in JEE as well as NEET exam. Okay, fine. Now let's proceed to the next set of questions. Now let's go to the second problem here. The second problem is like this. A liquid of mass M and density rho is filled in a tube AB of length L. The tube is rotated about end A with angular velocity omega. The force exerted at the other end B is. Okay. So now over here, the options given are like this. These are the four options given to us. Okay. And to solve this problem, I'll take use of Newton's laws of motion again. Okay. So let's take a look at the solutions to solution to this problem. Okay. Fine. Okay. To solve this problem, I'll make use of element technique. Okay, so small element method, so that particular technique we'll be adopting here, because that will give us a quick result and it will be more accurate. So let's draw this diagram first. Okay, so hope you can make out the diagram over here. As we can see, there is a rod. This rod we are seeing, okay, its length is L here, okay, and I am considering a small element dx. And this element dx I am considering at a distance x from end A. that is the suspended end A I am considering, and this is the liquid in which, in this tube, this liquid has been filled. Okay, I hope you all can make this out fine. Now let's go to the solution to this particular problem. As you all can notice here, this is a very simple technique that I am adopting. And one more thing, omega has been shown here as angular velocity. So obviously, if rod is rotated with respect to end A, end B will have angular motion, right? So that angular velocity has been indicated in the diagram. I hope you have drawn this diagram now. Okay, now let's go to the solution. Consider an element of length dx at a distance x from end A of the tube, AB. So as I was mentioning, that I have written here once again. Okay, then I can comfortably say that mass of the element of length dx can be calculated here. Fine. So mass of the element is nothing but what? Mass per unit length into length. Mass per unit length of that particular rod or tube is m by l multiplied by length of the element, which is dx. If we multiply these two, what we'll get? We'll be obtaining the mass of that particular elementary length dx. Okay, so that I have firstly calculated. Next step, I'll calculate the centripetal force. Now, centripetal force acting on the element is nothing but m omega square into r, where r is nothing but x here, as you all can notice in the diagram. So radius is x here. So accordingly, I'll be obtaining centripetal force on the tube at end B can be calculated by integrating this above equation as below. Okay, so as you can notice, I have integrated this particular equation. Okay, so and under what limit I can integrate? Under the limit of the length of the rod. So hence, a suspension is at point A, so obviously I'll say 0 to L. So that is x equal to 0 to x equal to L. That is the limit that we are having. So accordingly, I can very easily substitute the value of small m, that is mass, as m by L into dx into omega square into x. Okay, then if I readjust everything, I'll get the integral equation as m by L omega square into integral of 0 to L x into dx. And we know that integral of x into dx is x square by 2. Under the limit 0 to L, obviously I'll get it as m L omega square. Fine. So if you just make the integration, substitute the integral limits and simplify, we see that L and L, L square and L, they are dividing. So hence, in the numerator we'll have only the remaining L. So hence our answer is half ml omega square. So hence our answer, my friends, is option C here. I hope this particular approach is clear. Fine. So now let's move on to the next problem. Fine. The third problem is like this. A conical pendulum has a string of length L is equal to 50 cm and bob of mass M is equal to 200 gram. The bob is revolved in a horizontal circle of radius R is equal to 20 cm. If the string makes an angle theta is equal to 60 degree with the vertical, then the tension mentioned in Newton in the string and speed of the bob around the circle in meter per second are. So, and they, in the problem, they mentioned that we should take acceleration due to gravity as 10 meter per second square. And the options that are listed are as below. Okay, I hope these options you can make them out. Okay, anyways, I have sent you the set of questions as a PDF form, so you all can keep those problems in front of you while watching this solution video. That will help you. Fine. Okay, now let's go to the solution of this. Okay, now let's proceed to the solution. Firstly, we'll draw the diagram according to the given. So this is a conical pendulum that has been given. So accordingly, I have drawn this. Okay, as you all can notice here, the conical pendulum having a particular angle theta has been mentioned here, and that angle theta is given in the problem as 60 degree to us. Okay, so that we will substitute later, but right now we'll utilize everything in unknown form, and lastly we'll substitute all the values that have been given to us. Okay, so again here tension in that particular string I am taking it to be T. Okay, so accordingly what we'll get, we'll get two components of T here. One component, that is component which is vertical to the x-axis, so that y component is t cos theta and x component is t sin theta, because angle is with the vertical. Okay, so accordingly we are obtaining like this, and then I am also showing a vertically downward self weight of that particular object, that is mg here. Fine, so accordingly we are showing the free body diagram of this particular conical pendulum. Now let us write down the given factors. So here we have been given OQ as distance, OQ as radius we'll consider. Okay, so obviously it is radius of that circular path. Then PQ is the length L, okay, that has been given to us. Then I'm considering force towards center, that is centripetal force, which is nothing but T sine theta here, because this is a horizontal component of the tension T, and this T sin theta is obviously directed towards the center. So accordingly we are having these all components which have been given to us. Okay, now let's proceed to the solution. Now in order to solve this problem, firstly we'll consider the equilibrium condition. So under equilibrium we know that centripetal force, that is mv square by r, must be equal to T sin theta, because force towards center is T sin theta. So higagi, for that reason, what I am saying, mv square by r is equal to T sin theta. That we will take as equation number 1. Then mg is equal to T cos theta. So very clearly here, my friends, mg is self weight. Self weight is vertically downwards. T cos theta is vertically upwards. So accordingly, I am getting mg equal to T cos theta. So these are first two equations that I am marking as. Then from equation 2, I can calculate tension. Tension T can be calculated here. So T is equal to, we'll get mg by cos theta here, and if I substitute all the values given to us, then I'll get tension T as 4 newton here. I hope this is clear. So this is the first answer that we are looking for. Okay, then now let us go ahead and divide these equations. Equation 1 divided by equation 2 if we make, then v square divided by rg will give us tan theta, right? So then v can be written as under the root of r into g into tan theta. So accordingly we substitute the values that have been given to us, as r as 0.2 and g as 10 meter per second square, theta as 60 degree. So accordingly I'll be obtaining 1.86 meter per second as the speed of revolution. Okay, so I hope this is clear. So this is the linear velocity of that revolving object in this circular path. So accordingly our answers, which are which option matches here, option A here. So hence this problem has been solved quite easily, right? Okay, I hope this approach is clear. Now let's proceed to the next question. Fine, the next question is like this. A small sphere of mass m is equal to 500 gram moving on inner surface of a large hemispherical bowl of radius r equal to 5 meter describes a horizontal circle at a distance OC is equal to 2.5 meter below the center O of the bowl as shown in the figure. As you can notice, the figure is given here. The force exerted by the sphere on the bowl in Newton and the time period of revolution of the sphere around the circle in second r. Okay, again g has to be taken as 10 meter per second square here, and the options given to us are like this. Now to solve this problem, I have drawn this free body diagram. Here I am showing normal reaction force capital N from P to O towards that direction, because this is the normal reaction. Normal reaction will always act in the perpendicular direction, okay, and perpendicular to any curve is the perpendicular drawn to the tangent. I hope you know this from your mathematics basics. So accordingly, I am showing normal reaction here as capital N. Then angle theta is with the vertical. So hence we can write down the two components of N as N sin theta and N cos theta here. So accordingly, firstly we will write the given factors here. OP is given as radius R of the hemisphere, which is 5 meter, which is given to us. Then OC, distance OC is given as 2.5 meter, okay, and M is given as 0.5 kg. These are the given factors for us. Then cos theta can be calculated from this right angle triangle OCP as 1 by 2, okay. So accordingly, theta works out to be 60 degree for us. So we have calculated angle theta as our first step. Okay. So next, if we just proceed to the solution, here we can see that radius of the circle, that is circular path that particle P has to make, that circle, that radius I am taking as small c, and that radius is nothing but CP here, which can be written as OP sin theta. And OP is nothing but what, capital R here, radius, okay. So R sin theta, I am mentioning only this much right now, okay. Then figure shows a force acting on the sphere. That force acting on the sphere is capital N, which is normal reaction that I have already mentioned to you, okay. So therefore, force towards the center of the circle is nothing but N sin theta, which is the component, horizontal component of capital N, normal reaction. So that has been shown here. So accordingly, M omega square into R is equal to N sin theta. Once again, then next step, Mg is equal to N cos theta. This is again under equilibrium, these two equations I am obtaining, fine. So as you can notice the in the diagram, you can very easily find these facts, okay, fine. Then from equation 2, I can very easily calculate N, and we see that N is mg by cos theta. If we substitute all the values given to us in the problem, then N, that is normal reaction, works out to be 10 newton. That is one of our answer. Fine. Next, from equation 1, we can very easily find the next step, that is time period. In order to find time period, I have to find omega. So in order to do that, what I am doing, I am replacing small r as capital R into sin theta. Then omega works out to be root of N by mr. Okay. And omega has been found out to be 2 radian per second upon substituting all the values that have been given to us. Then accordingly, time period can be 2 pi by omega, which is obviously 2 pi divided by 2, which works out to be pi second, or which is nothing but 3.14 second. So that is our answer. So finally, our answer in this case is, my friends, let us consider the answer as 10 newton and 3.14 second. So accordingly, which option matches, you all can take a look at that, fine. So now let's move on to the winding up part of this particular discussion. Fine. So my friends, I have discussed these four important problems. So you solve these four problems. Once again, I'll come back with few more problems, and in my next discussion, I'll try to incorporate more problems on connected bodies, pulley system, okay, so that you people can have a lot of faithful solving in pulley based problems. And some of you also have requested a few things to me regarding some of the chapters. So I am keeping those chapters in my mind, and I will just try to come up with some problem based sessions once again. So I hope this part is clear, fine. So practice these all problems, fine. So thank you all for your patient listening and observing. I will come back with few more problems in the near future. So I hope these all problems are clear to you. Fine then. Thank you very much. Stay safe, stay healthy, and enjoy all your sessions that you are having with us. Okay, thank you very much. Have a nice time.